Wherever you are, raise your hands if you've been in a situation where people around you, maybe friends, families, or strangers, were speaking another language and you had no idea what they were saying. I know I have. And what do you do in those situations? Well, nowadays, it's pretty easy because of a glorious tool called Google Translate. But what about in the old days? Do you remember? Or just imagine, days before cell phones equipped with translators were at our fingertips. Well, we studied someone's verbal behavior to look for a context or a pattern in the word's usage to try and figure out what it meant, essentially finding its function. Was it only ever said when holding a certain item, like an orange? At certain times of the day, good night. During times of stress, help me. What's cool is this basic observation of behavior is also used in animal communication studies to determine the function of their vocalizations, such as finding prey or mates, competition, and alarm calls indicating stress. However, this is much easier to do in land-dwelling species. But what about in the mysterious deep, the ocean? There are many highly vocal marine species, such as whales, and they are facing numerous threats around the world, like overfishing, pollution, and climate change. One highly vocal species are humpback whales. Their claim to fame are their songs. Humpbacks produce these long, eloquent songs, mostly on their tropical breeding grounds, and this has been the main focus of most studies. In fact, if you've ever heard any whale vocalization, maybe on YouTube or the Planet Earth series, it was likely their songs. But that's only half the story. There's more. I study the short, weird, seemingly random non-song calls of humpbacks, which are understudied and not as well known. It's important to understand these calls because whales face many threats globally and could be calling for help or indicating stress, but we don't know it. These calls are produced all throughout the humpback range, from the tropics to thousands of kilometers away in their feeding grounds near the poles. We don't know the function of these non-song calls, so my goal is to look for consistent patterns in call activity across days and years as a first step to investigate function. To do so, we placed an underwater microphone in their feeding grounds and recorded humpback vocalizations. I analyzed hundreds of hours of recordings and identified calls into one of three call classes based on their acoustic properties. Now, the million-dollar question: what is the function? Preliminary results suggest humpbacks may use calls to maintain contact during feeding and migration. This is a first step to eventually understand and build up the vocabulary to develop a whale Google Translate. So if they're saying, "Help me," we can recognize the call and respond appropriately. Thank you.